am very interested in unintended consequences, that's for sure, because there are many of them. And you know, I didn't start out wanting to make this film. I started out trying to make a film in Afghanistan with a young woman who was very complicit in the filmmaking. And then after 3 years of working on it, she said, "I'm sorry, I'm too afraid to be in your film. Please take me out of it." And so that film collapsed. And it really made, you know, sort of blindsided me. I didn't see it coming, which was naive of me. And also, it was because of this moment in history that has shifted. So I come from, you know, 25 years past of documentary filmmaking, where to be attempt to be an ethical person, we thought we could promise to people we could control their images. That stopped being true in the early 2000s. It took longer to get to certain places like Afghanistan. But now that is no longer true in any kind of way. So what does that mean to try to be decent, to say to someone, "I will honor who you are or what you have shared with me," if you have no idea what will become of that image in the future? So that was the beginning of me looking back at things I had done in the past to say, you know, how has this played out? The thing that's peculiar about being the camera person, you really are different from the director. The director is thinking about what the film will become, who else needs to be filmed, but you are being asked to be in the moment, right? He's back there looking at me through the camera. He doesn't have to think about what question comes next. He's just observing. And often, if you're doing observational work with the camera, you're getting physically close to the person, you're developing a relationship of trust with the person, and that's what the director has asked you to do. But there may be some tension between, you know, sort of what is the vision of the film and your awareness. For example, there's a scene in my film where we're with a Bosnian grandmother who's being pushed to talk about the atrocities of the war. She clearly does not want to speak about it, and she's given many different responses to say, stop. And, you know, I couldn't help myself, and I interject, "Wow, you've got fabulous fashion sense. Have you always had it?" And she immediately burst into a smile and says, "Always." And it gets a laugh every time when I show a camera person. Because, you know, one thing that happens when you're doing human rights work, you tend to be asked to see people only as victims. And we know this is, you know, this is not what a human is only, even if they have suffered terrible things. So that tension around how do you reflect the complexity of a situation if your end goal is to sort of communicate a very specific idea or change a situation, that's what my film is questioning in a certain way. It's absolutely a group of scenes that all mean something very profound to me. But how I got to figuring out which scenes those were was this very remarkable process in which I would say I discovered that I carried a lot more trauma and loss in me than I had recognized. You know, when you're a camera person or any kind of person who's doing work in a world that is full of injustice, you're very present in the present. And I bet, you know, if I said to the camera person here or to you, "Where were you 2 weeks ago?" You have no idea. You've talked to so many people, right? And we're here in this moment. I'm here with you. We're all here together. And so I started to question, what does camera work do to my mind? You know, where is my capacity to remember? And so that was really fascinating in going back to the footage because, you know, I had filmed in this really difficult, awful situation in a hospital in Nigeria. And I always had this blurry image of the midwife in my mind. But when I went back to the footage, I could recognize every single person. Every pair of eyes that I had filmed in that hospital, I knew them. And where is that stored in me? That was the thing that became really interesting. And I was afraid for myself, I think, a little. But then when I started to bring this footage together, the thing that was crazy that I did was that I assembled all these moments that I felt were really important to me. We put them together into a 2.5 hour cut, and we watched it like, I mean, we call it the trauma cut affectionately now. I mean, it was like 6 genocides, 2 babies dying, some rapes, and I thought, because it was the tip of my iceberg of how many stories I had listened to, that other people could watch it. And that really blew me away because, you know, it really was the tip of my iceberg. And so then I got some distance from that. And one of the great things, I think, you know, with making things is we have craft, right? You get to worry about, is the sound okay? And is the f-stop okay? And you get to worry about, what's my next question? And these things help us cope with being in the emotionality of the moment. And so in some ways, you know, structuring a film, editing it, I realized, okay, I have tools to make this watchable. And one of the tools that we came up with was, instead of me talking about what I experienced as a camera person, let me show it. It's in the footage. Let me trust that it is in the footage and the audience can understand that. Because so much of what I was pushing back against was like, please, let's none of us simplify this. This is not simple. Being a human is not simple. Shifting the world is not simple. Making a film is not simple. There are a lot of people who are a part of it who are working as hard as they can, right? He's exhausted, you're exhausted, we're here, you know. And so that's what the film is for me, is a form of acknowledgement of the multiplicity of experience, so that you exist, I exist, he exists, and together we're making something in this moment. Well, you know, my experience with Bosnia is very particular. This is my fourth time here, and the film that I came to shoot here in 2006 called I Came to Testify, which is about the women from Foča who went to The Hague to talk about how they'd been raped and were responsible for rape being deemed a war crime. We made that film here. It has never shown in Bosnia. It has never shown in any of the countries of the region. So, you know, that sort of question of how does the struggle for human rights work through film if we struggle to make films and they cannot yet be seen? So in many ways, you know, that this festival exists and tries to show things that camera person could come here, and that the family that I filmed in Foča can come and be in this, you know. But I will say, you know, one of the women who's witnessed 99 from The Hague, she was too afraid to come to the festival. She doesn't get to see her film here. So I say once again, it is complicated. Human rights are complicated everywhere. They're particularly complicated here. But I think everyone is aware of them, whether they're burying them, speaking of them, fighting for them. We all know it's a part of this landscape. And I think that's what I love about Bosnia, and I love about this film festival.